It
He's
was
so
more.
tiny. Oh my gosh.
Tiny, tiny,
I
small
know. He's
little
just seven
thing.
now.
So
He's only seven now.
cute. Almost seven. Oh, I think he wants a bottle. Awesome.
He's hungry.
Oh my gosh, so cute.
That's my little boy.
Have you guys been getting a lot of sleep?
Not really, but I mean, I actually caught up on some sleep last night. I think I still have bags under my eyes like every day. We were up for like 3 days, 4 days in the hospital. And, when she could barely get any rest and was learning how to breastfeed there, I mean, you could ask her yourself about, I mean,
And the bed was uncomfortable, and C-section was uncomfortable, and it was just
God.
awful. Yeah.
So, I mean, how are you guys adjusting to being new parents? What has changed becoming a dad, becoming a mom?
I mean,
Keep it
I feel
real.
like our lifestyle, we're homebodies, so it's pretty easy to adjust to having a baby in the house.
Besides her postpartum breakdown the other day that she had, and it was 11:30 at night, and she's like, "I want to go shopping." I'm like, okay, like it's been 9 months. I
I
didn't
didn't.
ever to go shopping.
I
And
still haven't
packs
taken any, by the
four
way.
bags, puts only hair extensions in it and makeup, goes to her car. I walk outside with our boy, and I'm like, "Hey, don't leave your family." And I said, "I think you might be having a little bit of postpartum. Come here." And I gave her a kiss. "What's wrong, buddy? Mama like your mama?"
Are you gonna start, I guess, changing what you tweet or like posting? Like, are you just worried about?
Definitely. Not really. I think my son is going to grow up and see that his daddy is not someone to mess with. It's like my father. Not everybody liked him, but they loved him when they got to get to know him, But there was a demeanor about my father that I carry within me, and he passed away in 2017, and he was my world, as well as my mother. And, no. I mean, when he's 10 years old and he sees any of this stuff, I'll be like, "Hey, well, son, that was 10 years old. That was 10 years ago. And what are you doing even looking at that stuff? Like, get off, the media. Let's go play some basketball outside,
I have to ask about wedding plans. Is that still happening? What's going on there?
December 25th, we plan on getting married.
This
Small,
year.
yeah, this year. Hopefully. If not, we'll just wait till next Christmas. But I want us to get married on Christmas, and you're cool with that, right? So, and
Is
big
that
boy,
just gonna be like going to a local church? How is that gonna happen?
no, I'm gonna do a really cute, like small, wintry, like snow type of wedding with like 30 people max, because I have a small circle, and that's just kind of the way my life is and what I do. So like 30 people max in the snow, beautiful snow, her in her beautiful white dress. I'll wear probably a white tuxedo, and just as long as it has tails on it. And so I'll and I think that day is a great day because it's the day Jesus was born, and it's his birthday, and I've really given my life to God.
In terms of parenting, what are you enjoying? Obviously not the diaper changing,
Oh,
so.
I've you know what? All the above. It's all a beautiful blessing because I've had a lot of relationships, and I started kind of giving up on love and giving up on. I was talking about having a family years ago. Everybody saw that. I want to have, everyone saw that. When I did Impulsive podcast with Logan Paul, they saw that. And I said that I want to have a family, and I want to be able to just cook steaks and be at home and enjoy the love of my life and my child. And now that it's here, it's like an epiphany. It's like a eureka moment, and it's just every minute now has become so precious, and every bit of time that slips by now, I've switched my gears of thinking. And I've given a lot of people second chances, third chances, as you can see with us and the stuff that we've gone through. So whatever the world has problems with me, I just want to make you proud of me. And that's all I'm trying to do.